Yet another woman living alone has been murdered in her own home. Police believe 87-year-old Anne Redmond may have surprised a burglar. They're now urging other elderly southern suburbs residents to be vigilant. Reporter Hayley Connell joins us from Mrs. Redmond's Seacliff home. Hayley, do police have much to go on?
Well, Beck, they know Mrs. Redmond's fuse box was tampered with, but that's about all they have at this stage. They've spent the day scouring nearby streets and rail lines and have door-knocked about 100 homes, just searching for the breakthrough they need. 24 hours since major crime first descended on Anne Redmond's home, the fuse box on the side of the house remains their best clue.
This house's fuse box was open, and the lady on the other side, the same thing, and the power was turned off.
The 87-year-old was one of three Yacca Street residents to have their power cut, but it may be she was unlucky enough to come across the culprit in her backyard. It was there that her daughter found her dead.
She thought something was wrong, and her partner went round the back, or went there and found the mother lying on the back lawn.
A botched robbery is a possible motive. Police are now re-examining recent crimes in the area to see if fuse boxes have been tampered with elsewhere. They're urging anyone who hears noises outside their home to call a patrol. But they say vulnerable people living alone shouldn't have extra reason for fear, even though three women have been killed in their Adelaide homes in just 4 months.
Solving this and similar crimes will always be a priority for us.
That was just the start of a busy night for major crime. By 2 in the morning, a 30-year-old Salisbury North man lay dead at Osborne. He'd been glassed in the neck.
I was on the phone to Triple O and they were asking us to, or telling me to perform CPR on a bloke.
A 29-year-old man's been charged with murder, and another three men have been charged with killing a man at South Plimpton just half an hour later. The 29-year-old victim was repeatedly kicked in a wild brawl in Vincent Street. Two other men were taken to hospital. Hayley Connell, 10 News.